Great prophet that we read about in the Quran Kareem, Sulaiman, as we know him as Solomon. Sulaiman alayhi salam is the son of Dawood. Sulaiman alayhi salam inherited from his father the prophecy and the leadership. So Sulaiman alayhi salam had a kingdom where no one ever had before and no one in the future will have. And the kingdom that Sulaiman alayhi salam he had is a great kingdom. That the kingdom of Sulaiman is a miracle within itself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had gave Dawood and Sulaiman a knowledge of a lot of things that many people didn't have. The scholars say two Muslims ruled the world and two non-Muslims ruled the world. The two Muslims who ruled the world are Sulaiman alayhi salam and Dhulqarnayn. And Dhulqarnayn is a great righteous leader who was not a prophet but a righteous man who came before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and after Isa alayhi salam. And Sulaiman alayhi salam who ruled the world, the east and the west, and he had the whole world under his hand. And the two non-Muslims who ruled the world were Namrud, and that was, and he came before Musa alayhi salam, and Bukhtanassar. And Bukhtanassar, he came and he was an anti-Jew that slaughtered the Jews and killed many of them. And the most powerful one out of all of them who really ruled the whole world and had that power was Sulaiman alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the strength and the power and the leadership in Sulaiman, and it was in the hands of Sulaiman alayhi salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Sulaiman alayhi salam the ruling of the east and the west, and Sulaiman alayhi salam was granted many of the great miracles. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Sulaiman alayhi salam the understanding of the language. In this verse, as Allah says, the language of the birds. And Sulaiman did not only understand the language of the birds, but Sulaiman understood the language of the animals. And this is a miracle itself. He understood what the animals speak. And this is a miracle. It's not something that you could learn. And Allah Azza wa Jal had gathered together unto Sulaiman alayhi salam the armies from mankind and the jinn and the tayr and the birds. The jinn are the jinn that we know, or the ghosts or the spirits. And some of the scholars say the reason that Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned the jinn before the ins is because his army of the jinn was much bigger than the army of the ins. When Sulaiman alayhi salam used to call them for an assembly or a gathering, they will all stand lining up in order. The jinn, the ins, and the birds in the air protecting them from the sun. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's miracle. This is Allah azza wa jalla's gift to Sulaiman alayhi salam. So he was a powerful king. He was a powerful leader. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had accepted his dua when he said, Habli munkan la yanbaghi li ahadin min ba'di. Give me a kingdom that would never ever be granted to anyone before me or after me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted that kingdom to Sulaiman alayhi salam. One day, Sulaiman alayhi salam was walking with a great army. An army of the human beings, mankind. An army of the jinn, an army of the animals. And they used to get scared from Sulaiman alayhi salam. He had strong personality that the jinn would get so scared from Sulaiman alayhi salam. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, until Sulaiman, when he was walking and traveling with his army, he went past a valley of ants. One of those ants saw Sulaiman alayhi salam and his army coming, marching to towards them. So Allah says in the Quran al-Kareem, قَالَتْ نَمْلَةٌ, one ant out of the ants from the valley of ants said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّمْلُ, she called upon the ants and she said, oh ants, ادخلوا مساكنكم, go hide into your places, into your houses, which is underground, before Sulaiman and his army destroys you. Look at this massive army. Sulaiman and his army will destroy you and demolish you without them realizing. So Allah Azza wa says, فَتَبَسَّمَ ضَاحِكَ, he smiled. Who? Sulaiman alayhi salam. He understood what the ant spoke and said to the other ants, or communicated to the other ants. He smiled, laughing. Oh Allah, give me the strength to thank you for what you have granted me and granted my parents, my predecessors. وَعَلَى وَالِدَيَّ وَأَنْ أَعْمَلَ صَالِحًا. Ya Allah, give me the strength. Give me the strength. Grant me the strength to do the righteous deed. Allah Azza wa Jalla gave Sulaiman the armies of the jinn. They work under his command. Under the command of Sulaiman. Whatever Sulaiman orders the jinn, they must do. And not only that, بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِ, that's all by the will of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So the jinn were commanded and ordered by Allah Azza wa Jalla to obey Sulaiman alayhi salam. Well, that are a creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with different abilities and strength than us. They were building to him temples. The jinn used to build temples for Sulaiman alayhi salam. Massive temples that human beings can put together. That's how powerful they were. They used to be around Sulaiman alayhi salam, build things for Sulaiman, make things for Sulaiman. This is the ability and the strength that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the jinn, and he did not give to us. The jinn. He had the ability to punish the jinn. Us, an average person or the normal creation of Allah Azza wa Jalla, mankind, we can't see the jinn. We can't even feel or touch the jinn. They could see us, we can't see them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the ability to Sulaiman to see them, to touch them, to punish them, to lock them up. And when he used to command them, they must obey. And whoever should not obey, Sulaiman had the ability to punish him. And Allah Azza wa Jalla will punish him in this dunya and the hereafter, as some of the scholars mentioned. Also, Allah Azza wa Jalla gave Sulaiman the strength of the wind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Sulaiman alayhi salam that whatever he commands, the wind will do. He'll tell the wind, go this way, we'll go that way. Go that way, we'll go this way. And when Sulaiman wanted rain, he'll command the wind to push the clouds together so it could rain at a particular place. Sulaiman alayhi salam was given to him the ability of raging the wind, of moving the wind however he wants. All this by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Sulaiman married 1,000 female. Sulaiman alayhi salam married 1,000 female. Sulaiman was given that permission. All prophets and messengers come with one religion, and that's a religion of Islam, but they come with different sharia, different laws, different rulings. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, one day Sulaiman said that I'm gonna go and visit, which I share love with 100 women tonight. He said, I'm gonna go and visit 100 women of my women, and I want each one of those women to fall pregnant with a child that I will use in the path of Allah. And he did not say inshallah. So what happened? Out of those 100 females, only one fell pregnant, and she gave birth to a half a child. She gave birth to half a child. Whether he was half in any way, Allahu A'lam. If he said inshallah, then each one of those women that he went and visited that night would have given a birth to a child or fought in the path of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So this is how important it is for someone to say, inshallah, these are prophets and messengers, and Allah Azza wa Jal also created them as human beings, and the human being forgets, subhanAllah. So Allah Azza wa Jal tested Sulaiman with that half a child. From that day he said, قَالَ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي, oh Allah, forgive me. And this is a famous story about Sulaiman alayhi salam, Sulaiman and the queen of Sheba or Saba. Saba is a city, a town, a famous town in Yemen. Sulaiman alayhi salam was in Jerusalem, Palestine. One day, Sulaiman alayhi salam was looking for a special bird, the hoopoe, al-hudhud. And one special bird that Sulaiman alayhi salam used to use to go and get him information wasn't there. So Sulaiman alayhi salam got angry. How could the hoopoe go and not take permission from Sulaiman? Why can't I see it? Where is it? I'm kana min al-ghaibin. Is it absent without my permission? Once that hoopoe comes, I'm gonna punish it, a severe punishment. And the scholars say the punishment that Sulaiman wanted to punish that bird, a lot of the scholars say Sulaiman alayhi salam was gonna put that bird with a different race of other birds. Or I'm gonna slaughter it, or أو لا يأتيني بسلطان مبين. Or he's gonna come with a good excuse. Unless that hooper, that bird comes with a good excuse, then I'm not gonna punish it. فمكث غير بعيد. This hooper came after a while and stood just a bit far away from Sulaiman alayhi salam. That bird straight away spoke to Sulaiman alayhi salam, saying, أحط بما لم تحط به. Oh Sulaiman, I have knowledge of such knowledge that you don't even know. There is an important information that you need to know. And this information, I know it before you know it. And then Sulaiman alayhi salam listened. And this bird says, إني وجدت امرأة تملكهم. The amazing thing is about that Siri Sheba, their leader, their head is a woman, is a queen. And at that time, and before that time, and many centuries after that time, it wasn't common for a woman to lead a nation. And she has everything. She has the power, she has the wealth, she has the army, she has the kingdom, she has everything around her. وَلَهَا عَرْشٌ عَظِيمٌ. And she has a mighty throne, a great throne. They say her throne was so big, so massive, was decorated with so many different pearls and jewelries, so many different gold and silver. This queen, this leader of theirs, prostrating to the sun, her and her nation. The bird was so concerned, how could such a woman prostrate to the sun? And this is something not acceptable. So Sulaiman responded back. He said, if you, what you're saying is the truth, I'm not going to punish you. But if you tend to be lying, I am going to punish you, a severe punishment, or I'm going to slaughter you. Sulaiman alayhi salam had written a letter. He gave it to that bird and he said, go and give them this letter and see what they come back with. So that bird took that letter and dropped her off to the queen of Sheba. When she received that letter from Sulaiman alayhi salam, she called upon her people and she said, إني ألقي إلي كتاب كريم. I just received a noble letter. إنه من سليمان. This letter is from Sulaiman. And definitely everyone knows who Sulaiman alayhi salam. Sulaiman, the most powerful man at that time. Everyone knows who Sulaiman is. And everyone hears of Sulaiman and the amazing miracles that take place on the hands of Sulaiman. It's saying in the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. Sulaiman written in that letter, do not have pride over me and surrender to me. Going to send to Sulaiman a lot of presents. And she did. She sent the best of presents to Sulaiman alayhi salam. And she said, فَنَاظِرَةٌ. I'll see what's the response. Maybe the presents can back Sulaiman off away from us. فَلَمَّا جَاءَ سُلَيْمَانُ. When Sulaiman received the presents, قَالَ أَتُمِدُّونَنِي بِمَالٍ. Are you trying to deceive me? You want to increase my wealth? فَمَا أَتَانِيَ اللَّهُ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا أَتَاكُمْ. Can't you see what Allah had given me? What Allah had given me is a lot better than what you've got. Don't try and deceive me with wealth. Allah's given me the best thing. I'm gonna go out with an army that no one had ever seen before. Send that news to her. If she does not come within a certain time or period, I'll come to her with an army that she's never experienced. قَالَ يَا أَيُّهَا الْمَلَأُ أَيُّكُمْ يَأْتِينِ بِعَرْشِهَا قَبْلَ أَن يَأْتُونِ مُسْلِمِينَ. The news went to Balqis the queen of Sheba, so she surrendered. And she came to Sulaiman alayhi salam with her army from Yemen to Jerusalem. Sulaiman alayhi salam wanted to show her that his kingdom's from Allah Azza wa Jalla. So Sulaiman alayhi salam, he heard about her throne, and he has his army from the jinn and the human beings and the birds and the army of the wind. He gathered his army alayhi salam and said, أيكم يأتيني بعرشيا قبل أن يأتوني مسلمين. As you all know now, the queen of Sheba and all the people of Sheba coming to Jerusalem. I want one of you to go and get me his throne from Yemen here before they come. Ifrit, one of the heads and the leaders of the jinn, said, أَنَا أَأْتِيكَ بِهِ قَبْلَ أَن تَقُومَ مِن مَقَامِكَ. I'll get you her throne before you get up from your seat. Seconds. And I am strong and trustworthy to get her. Sulaiman was amazed himself. SubhanAllah. Within a blink of an eye, the throne was there. When Sulaiman saw the throne, what kind of a miracle is that? It's an amazing miracle. Now Sulaiman alayhi salam is waiting for the queen of Sheba, Bilqis, to come. Now Bilqis comes with an army to surrender to Sulaiman. And Sulaiman alayhi salam wanted to teach her. This is all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When she came, فَلَمَّا جَاءَتْ, when she arrived, Sulaiman asked her, أَهَاكَذَا عَرْشِكِ. He told her, is this your throne? Is that like your throne? She was amazed. قالت كأنه, it looks like it. But at the back of her mind, impossible, I wasn't going to come here. Sulaiman said, that's your throne. When she saw that, she was amazed. How did the throne come here? Sulaiman wanted to teach her that this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sure, she saw something that you can't even dream of, ya ikhwani. When she saw that, she said, Ya Allah, I surrender to you, Ya Allah, with Sulaiman. I surrender to you, Ya Rabbil Alameen. And she surrendered to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She became a Muslim. And the narration says that Sulaiman alayhi salam also got married to her. Sulaiman alayhi salam passed away while he was sitting on his throne. And the jinn was so afraid to make any movement without the orders of Sulaiman alayhi salam, and he stayed on that throne, some scholars say, for days, until a creeping creature came and ate that stick that Sulaiman was leaning on. And that's when Sulaiman fell and they realized that they didn't know the answer, and he was buried in Jerusalem.
خصك الرحمن بالفضل والفضل.